So a notification popped up in my calendar today, said I needed to descale the tankless heater. Got the two service hoses attached to the service or flush ports. And then what I did this time finally is I printed out the instructions, put them in one of these clear plastic sleeves with an old fridge magnet attached on the back. And that way I can just put that up here and refer to the instructions if I need to. So last year I followed the manufacturer's recommendations and used white vinegar. I think I used 2.5 gallons. So the cost on the white vinegar was around $10. The manufacturer actually recommends 5 gallons, maybe in a much larger heater. I think their instructions must apply to all their different heaters. But this one is small enough, I just don't see why you would need that much. And this year I thought I would use something like Dezcal, which is a descaling powder for coffee machines, espresso machines. The inside of a coffee or espresso machine is very similar to this. There's a bunch of plumbing, there's a heat exchanger. These run at lower temperatures, 140 Fahrenheit instead of 190 Fahrenheit, but it should be very similar. So I showed you in the previous video where I made my own Descal powder. So I figured I would use about 8 ounces or 1/2 pound in 2.5 gallons of water. So here's my water bucket. I'll dump that in. The one thing with this powder, you need to dissolve it before you use it, unlike vinegar, which you can use right out of the bottle. According to the directions, it says set the unit to the highest temperature. And so I'll flip over to my local priority on the switch, and then we'll go here. I'm right at 125. 140 is the hottest it goes. And then it says run the hot water for a couple of minutes. So here we go, hot water on. I had one question on what kind of water flow does this faucet give with this utility sink. So there's the stream mode, 1.3 gallons a minute. And there's the spray mode. That really sprays out of there, 1.2 gallons a minute. And I'm coming up a little over 2 gallons. Yeah, so I was going to stop there a little short of 2.5 gallons because when I open up the service valves on the heater, there's going to be the water inside is going to come out. Yeah, it seems to be pretty well dissolved already with just the hot water. So one thing I wanted to do here was check the pH. Looks like we're about 9/10 or 1.0. So I figured I would check the pH before I started, and then I want to check it after I finish. If the pH goes up, that means the amount of acidity has gone down. So I just want to make sure that this kind of mix provides a reasonable amount of acidity afterwards. You're supposed to kill the power. Now you don't want to turn the unit off. You want to unplug it. And there goes the power. It's off. So that's important. You need to kill the power. Do not turn it off, because if you turn the unit off, some of the internal valves might close. And then you think you're cleaning the inside of the unit, but it's just circulating water in and out. Okay, now we come in and we've got to close
water valves.
So there's the cold inlet. Get that one over there. And there's the hot outlet. So, and then I open up the service ports here, right there, and I've already hooked up the hoses. I think it works better to hook up the hoses before. This is the cold water, so I'm going out of the pump into the cold inlet of the heater, and then here's the hot returning, and it just goes into the bucket. And let's plug this pump into my solar power inverter here. And there you go. There's the hot water return line. I'll come back in about 45 minutes so we can see what things look like. Okay, YouTube, there we're at the end of about 45 minutes. Actually, I don't think I need to run this long next time. I think 30 minutes is probably plenty. After about 15, the water cleared right up, and you can see here the floating sludge So that's the aluminum sulfate in there. As I mentioned in the previous video, binds with the dissolved minerals, causes them to float to the surface. But yeah, that's quite a bit that came out of there. But yeah, that's the aluminum sulfate action right there. So I think big thumbs up on that. That works very well. One other advantage of this that I hadn't noticed before, and you won't be able to tell on video, but there's no smell. You don't smell anything with this, just hot water. So yeah, no odor. That is a big win, because you have 2.5-3 gallons of vinegar pumping around, and you can definitely smell it for quite a while, but this has no odor at all. So here's my pH meter. Yeah, it's come up. So yeah, we used a little bit of the acid. It's up to 1.2 pH. It was a little under 1.0. Yeah, I think that's a good mix, not overkill, and it didn't completely disappear. But yeah, I think that worked pretty good. So let's get a little bit of context here. So I went and looked up a couple of commercial descalers. This one's called Haymaker Descaler. I think it's sold by Odie. This is a citric acid. It's a liquid concentrate. I think it comes in a 32-ounce, 1-quart bottle, 955 milliliters, $19.22. And then I found this one. It's by Rector Seal. It's a powder. This one appears to be 100% sulfamic acid, $19.34 for 1.3 pounds, about a half a kilogram. And then this one is quite a popular descaler. A lot of plumbers seem to recommend this. It's called Flow-Aide, and it's a hydrochloric acid-based cleaner, like muriatic acid would be the other name for it. Really expensive though, a 2-pack, $100, but about $50 a bottle. And I think one bottle makes one batch of descaling liquid. A plumber would probably pay that, $50, because he's probably charging $200 for the flushing service. You can see anywhere from $20 to $50 to descale. Using Dezcal powder, you would use about a quarter of this 1 kilogram bottle, which is about $4.50. Using my homemade Dezcal product, $1.25. So I don't think you can get much less expensive than that. So I guess the reason I'm a bit obsessed about the cost of this descaling solution is last year I spent about $12 in natural gas to run the tankless water heater. Now, if I have to go and spend $50 a year to descale it, I'm spending 4 times as much on this bottle of descaling solution as I am on an entire year of hot water. That just doesn't make sense. But if I use my own homemade mix, $1.25, so my maintenance cost is about 10% of the operating cost. That sounds reasonable. So let's see, the next thing we need to do is flush this with some clear water. So I taken the hose off the pump and hooked it up to my faucet here. And now we're supposed to flush for 15 minutes. Okay, we should be finished flushing there. Last 5 minutes or so, I hooked the hose coming out of the water heater into the outlet of the pump, and that back flushes the pump, get all the citric acid out of it. You close these valves, so that shuts off the service ports. And before I open up the other valves, I want to check the inlet filter. And that's one thing I added to the instructions here. They kind of say replace the water filter, but it's a screen, so unless it's really damaged, I don't see why you have to replace it. And there's a little bit of water in there. Yeah, so that could use a little bit of cleaning. I'll let that soak for a few minutes, and then we'll brush it off, put it back in, and then turn the heater back on. Yeah, I think we got the inlet filter cleaned off there, let it soak for a while, and then I ran a toothbrush inside and outside and blew it out a little bit. I think that's good. Just get that back in here before we turn on any water. There we go. I think that's full. And then we turn this one on. There's the hot. The only thing left is plug it back in. There it comes up. No errors displayed. Valves are all clicking. Yeah, so let's see if it fires up. I'll go over to hot water on the faucet. And there we go, in use. Oh yeah, there we go. Hot water. So I think we're back online. Yeah, so I'll just put my descaling instructions over here on the back side. They're out of sight. They'll be there for next time. Then I just coil up my pump and hoses, and then the idea is I put them behind the cabinet of the utility sink. But yeah, hope you enjoyed that. So this is descaling a tankless water heater with a citric acid based descaling solution. Homemade, total cost about $1.25. Yeah, if you have any questions, post up in the comments section below, and I'll put links to my previous descaling with vinegar, and then I'll put a link to the video on making the descaling solution over here. Any questions, post up in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching.